this challenge is more than 80% mental. If your mind's not in the right place, you're never gonna complete this challenge.
The first night was kind of weird without Tanner. I'm just kind of quiet. Not a lot of talking before bed. We just kind of passed out.
Yeah, it was a tiring day for sure.
Our morale is still a little shaken up with Tanner leaving yesterday, but he is gone and he's not coming back. So we have to continue on with our challenge in front of us.
Excited to see about getting some seafood today.
So exciting.
Definitely need some protein in our life. Goals, like major goals, protein.
We've been hydrating quite a bit this morning.
Mm-hmm.
It's good. Time to head on to the ocean. Lead the way.
Today's my day number one. My ankle is feeling a lot better. So I'm going to make the hike down to the coast with Ayosha so that we can try to get some protein. I'm so, so grateful to be able to focus on the tasks at hand.
The smell of the sea.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely pretty low already.
Yeah.
Low tide's gonna be key. When those tide pools are potentially gonna be full of little, you know, animals, crabs, whatever else is in there, that get trapped as that tide recedes. We're gonna be using our hand line and also the basket that we made. We're feeling pretty confident about the ocean and getting some food there. Nice and slow.
Rock.
How you feeling?
My heart is just like pounding really hard.
Okay.
Let's let my heart rate come down.
So, you want to try to throw a line in the water?
Sure.
While I work the basket? Maybe?
Sure.
We're definitely getting pretty hungry. My body's definitely feeling the lack of protein. Brittany's feeling a little discomfort as well.
I'm smashing a hermit crab shell so that I can use the hermit crab for bait. You seeing any fish?
Yeah.
There's mullet all in here.
There's a bunch of these tiny little striped fish, but they're just really cautious.
Damn it. Gotta find a way to put the bait on better because the fish just stole my shit. Oh, it's just frustrating. How stupid are fish, do you wonder?
Damn. I don't think that basket's gonna work in this shallow water. It's just too big, like they're not gonna let me get anywhere near them. Realizing that it's not really gonna work out super well unless we find an area that's got some deeper water. So I'm ditching that plan and going with just more scavenging approach. A lot of good sized churros in here. Those are gonna be tasty. Churros are little snail-like things.
I'd love a big octopus right now.
See if I can find some decent-sized urchins. Not much food in them, but it's something. And they do not run away from you. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about right there.
Obviously, it takes a lot of trial and error, which takes a lot of energy, which we're running low on, just from no really good protein source. These chest pains are just unlike anything I've ever experienced.
Yeah, your body's definitely lacking a lot of things right now.
It hurts.
Let me see your pulse. Yeah, that's quick. Okay, well, if you want to just sit for a minute, we can head back to camp soon.
Sounds good.
I'm just going to harvest a few more urchins. There is no shortage of them. Every single hole in these rocks has one in there. Man, these urchins are just a pain. Get out. That when you're hungry enough, you'll eat just about anything. All right, we got ourselves some lunch.
Nice.
I think I'm about ready to head back. All right. How's the pain doing?
Fine.
Cool. I can go up. You can pass up the basket and the pot.
Yeah.
Just spending a good chunk of time wandering around those tide pools, picking up stuff, which doesn't take much energy, and actually get us a good meal is really big.
My chest is hurting.
That's right here.
It hurts.
The heart is not something you want to take lightly. She's saying it feels like it's like pounding out of her chest.
Out of an abundance of caution, producers call in the medic to check Brittany's blood pressure.
That's like right at 130. Your body is going into like a starvation mode, and so it's going to start breaking down muscle. We don't want to just feed off of the muscle in your heart. You got to make sure you get some food so it stops breaking down your muscle.
If my heart doesn't start feeling better, I'm worried for the worst.
Lunchtime. Excited for this meal. It's gonna feel really good. Got a nice little pile of them right there. Got a couple of really big churros. Just get these puppies going.
He's still moving.
Yeah, they're alive. There's not much in there, but something. If you just scoop.
How does it taste?
It's good. You just have to not like be like, oh, it's gross. I'll give you a nice big one. It's got a lot of meat in it. See that orange stuff?
I can officially say I know the weirdest thing I've ever eaten.
Like, put it in your mouth. Just eat it. Just put it in your mouth. It's really not bad.
Yeah, it's not bad. It tasted like I was eating straight salt water, but in a hummus form. Like the blah, blah, blah. I'm so grateful for the sea urchin, but I'm gonna pass since there's no way. It's just not for me.
All right.
I'll eat churros and stuff, though. Really? You're a dork.
All right, I think those are good. They're boiling. I feel very close to Brittany. She's really sweet and very supportive, and I know that having her out here with me is gonna be a big part of helping me get through this. How are you feeling about these?
Not bad.
They're chewy, you gotta just nip off that head bit.
That feels good, eating something.
Really felt good to get some food in my stomach.
That one had some sand in it.
Brittany had about 10 of those churros, really hoping that it makes her feel better. What's the pain doing?
It hurts.
Take some deep breaths.
I'm still experiencing a lot of discomfort and pain associated with my heart right now.
It might be easiest if you just lie back for a moment.
My mom's only 57, and 5 years ago, she had a mini stroke. And with my family history, it just makes me panic. It feels like somebody's taking a stress ball and just squeezing the out of it. Oh, it hurts. I know I'm strong. I know I can do it. I feel like I'm gonna pass out from the pain.
You got it, I'm sorry.